Hello friend, welcome to another video lecture about the topic satellite communication. So before going to start about this lecture, you already know that basic concept of satellite, that is what is a satellite. Then you know different type of satellite. Then what are the needs of satellite and different elements present in a satellite. So in this lecture we are going to cover mostly one topic, that is what is the block diagram of satellite communication system and their working and principle. So let's start. So these are the content we are going to cover in this topic, that is block diagram of satellite communication, and their working and principle. So this is a basic block diagram of satellite communication. Okay, so here there is a ground station. Okay, so just check, that is source part or transmitting part, and you use as a channel as a uplink. Okay, this is a channel where you use that channel to send information or any baseband signal. And here it is a satellite which is present in space. Satellite work as a transponder which both receive the signal which is sent through this source or this ground stations, and again it resend to the destination through a channel, it is called downlink. Okay, this is a basic flow diagram of satellite communication. So earth station transmit the signal to the satellite. A high directional by using a high directional antenna. Here you already know that there is a earth station present in transmitting part. So by using a high directional dish antenna, it transmits the signal to the satellite by the help of or by the use of channel, that is uplink frequency. Then the transmitter transmits the signal from satellite to earth station through a channel, is called downlink. Ground or from base station to satellite, you use the channel uplink. For satellite to again the ground or the destination, you use downlink as a channel. So this is the actual block diagram of a satellite communication. Here this part is the transmitting section, this part is the receiving section, and this is the satellite used for communication or satellite communication. In transmitting station there is a users where they generate the baseband signal, then through a terrestrial network we transmit the data to the earth station, then through earth station you use as a uplink frequency to as a channel to transmit the data to the carrier information, carrier signal to satellite. Then again here amplify the signal, then it transmit to the earth station by downlink frequency. Here again through a terrestrial network again R test 1 to is sent to the user and we get the information at receiver section. So here you use as a uplink frequency, that is uplink or downlink frequency, that is 6 by 4 gigahertz frequency. 6 by 4 gigahertz frequency. For uplink frequency you use 6 gigahertz frequency, or for downlink you use 4 gigahertz frequency. Why there is a difference between uplink frequency and downlink frequency? To overcome or to avoid the interference between the signal. So always uplink frequency is greater than downlink frequency. There is other also uplink downlink frequency band, that is you can take 40 gigahertz and 12 gigahertz band. Okay, so this is the process where we have a transmitting sensor and another is the receiving section. So next, so the user generate a baseband signal which is processed through a terrestrial network. So the user generate a baseband signal which is processed through terrestrial network to the R test one. For terrestrial network is mostly maybe a telephone switch or any dedicated link which is to the R test one. Okay, then repeater. Here repeater is used, repeater circuit is used which is increase the strength of receiving signal and transmit to the satellite. So a repeater circuit is play a very important role, which is receive the signal, then it's increase the strength of the signal, then transmit to the satellite through a communication channel, that is uplink frequency. Okay, and it work as a transponder. Satellite work as a transponder. Okay, so this is the basic R-tesson of transmitter and receiver. R-tesson, this is the flow diagram of or block diagram of R-tesson of transmitter as well as receiver, where the user generate the baseband signal, okay, which is analog signal, then it's feed to the encoder. This is a encoder convert the baseband signal to digital bits, trail of digital bits, that is 0 and 1. Then it's fed to the modulator that convert into a carrier signal. Okay, modulator into a carrier signal, then it's fed to the op converter. It's increase the signal strength, then through a high power amplifier it pass to the antenna. Okay, so the up converter convert that carrier signal to frequency uplink frequency range, because we use as a communication channel, that is uplink frequency. So it's convert to uplink frequency range, then passes through a power amplifier. In power amplifier, it's amplify the signal strength because it's travel lot of distance. So we need to amplify that signal. Okay, then through an antenna, it's go to the satellite. Again, after received by satellite, then again transmit to noise amplifier. Okay, a low noise amplifier. Then it is convert to down converter. Okay, down converter because through satellite it's convert to down converter to specific frequency range, that is down link frequency. Okay, then demodulator used to get original or baseband signal, again decoded to an analog signal, then you get the baseband signal at destination. Okay, this is the process of transmitter as well as receiver of our tesla. So in this lecture we learned about block diagram of satellite communications and what their working and principle. So thank you.